Hi, welcome to my UPSC civil service examination preparation. In this part, we'll discuss about rejuvenation. Okay, now let's start with the explanation. What is rejuvenation? Okay, the rejuvenation is nothing but accelerating the erosive power of a fluid processes. Okay, it's called as rejuvenation. Fluid processor is the erosion activities which are carried out by river. And the other form of water types of sources is called as fluvial processes. So what causes this acceleration of erosive power? So the causes are given here. The elevation of a sea level. You know, we all know that the vertical erosion of a particular fluvial process goes on until it reached the base level. The base level is nothing but sea level. When the sea level is lowered, okay, suppose the sea level is lowered, then the capacity, then the tendency of a river to have vertical erosion still increases. So it will have vertical erosion till here. So there is an interruption in the fluvial cycle of erosion. Okay, the other thing is upliftment of landmass. Suppose a river has eroded till here. This is a sea level. Okay, now the landform, there is an upliftment due to endogenic factors. So when it uplifts, it goes here. So again, the sea level is down. So tendency of the river to have vertical erosion increases until the base level. So this process interrupts the normal cycle of erosion by which the river will have extended length of cycle of erosion. Suppose if a particular river which is in its senile stage or old stage, okay, which will be characterized by widen and shallow valley, so it gets rejuvenated. So there will be vertical erosion which will take back from old stage to youth stage again. So there will be lengthening in fluvial cycle of erosion. Okay, now types of rejuvenations are dynamic, eustatic and static. What are dynamic rejuvenation? The rejuvenations by upliftment of landmass and landmass tilting of landmass is called as dynamic rejuvenation. What is eustatic rejuvenation? The rejuvenations which are caused due to lowering of sea floor or upliftment or a rise in the coastal rise of the landmass. Suppose this is a coastal area, the coastal land rises. This is the eustatic rejuvenation. What is static rejuvenation? The rejuvenation which is caused by the outflow, as the outflow of a river increases due to heavy rainfall. Okay, the volume of the river increases. Such type of rejuvenation is called as static rejuvenation. Okay, what is the rejuvenation effect? It increases the fluvial cycle of erosion. Usually, all landform in the fluvial processes which are developed under fluvial processes undergo a cycle of erosion from youth to mature to old. Okay, this is a cycle. When the landform in the mature stage or youth stage, old stage gets rejuvenated, it is taken back to youth stage. So again, it has to pass through the cycle. So there will be increase in the cycle, or the length of the cycle of erosion increases. So this is the effect. Okay, now let's come to the important point. Okay, the topographies which are developed by these rejuvenations. Okay, okay, the topographies developed by these rejuvenations are, one is multi-storied valley. What is multi-storied valley? This is multi-storied valley. Okay, let me explain this. Okay, now suppose consider this valley. This is the valley in the senile or old stage, characterized by wide and shallow. Suppose this gets rejuvenated due to lowering of sea level. So there will be vertical erosion. So the river will be like this. Okay, the tendency of it to have vertical erosion will increase. So it gets stepped like this. Okay, so this is a new valley. This is the old valley. So this is valley inside a valley. So this is called multi-stored valley. Okay, when the cycle repeats again, there will be again step. That is valley inside a valley inside a valley. So this type of valleys are called, which are formed due to rejuvenation, is called multi-stored valley. Understand? Okay, now let's take uplifted peneplain. Suppose a valley is uplifted like this. Okay, the remnants of the previous elevated things, such as this is a valley. Okay, this is the terrace. Okay, river, the terraces. Okay, suppose here the uplifted of the previous valleys are present like this. These are uplifted peneplains. Okay, which consist of monad rocks and all. Okay, usually it's a convex, concave hill residuals will be there here. Now, what is inside meanders? Inside meanders are during the old stage of a particular river, it will be meandering. Okay, meander, characterized by shallow water, shallow depth. Okay, shallow depth is very small depth. So when there is a rejuvenation, it will have a tendency of vertical erosion increases. So the meanders will undergo vertical erosion rather than lateral erosion. So the depth of the valley of the meanders increases. So the meanders will get deepen. The depth increases. So the depth increases of a widened meander is called as incised meanders. That is, the meanders which is of shallow depth will have vertical erosion, and it will have steep depth with narrow width. So it is incised meanders. What are neck points here? As shown here, the breaks present in the breakpoints present in the longitudinal course of a slope of a valley, of a multi-stored valley, is called as neck point. What is river terraces? River terraces is nothing but a flat surfaces present on the river floor. Okay, these are the flat surfaces, stepped flat surfaces, which are usually caused due to rejuvenation. So these are the topography of a rejuvenation. Okay, usually the landforms which are formed due to rejuvenations are called polycyclic landform. Polycyclic. Okay, how can we classify this? Okay, when the valley of a particular river is not uniform from the top point to bottom point, then such type of topography formed due to rejuvenation is called as topographical unconformity. Okay, topographical unconformity. That's it with respect to topography formed by the rejuvenation. It was asked in the previous year question paper also. It's an important topic. Okay, I have made notes here. You can refer this. I'll share the link of the PDF also. Okay, if you have understood the concept, please like, share and subscribe. Okay, that's it for today. I'll explain each and every concept clearly in the next coming videos of other concepts in geography. Okay, thank you.